package from Speed Cube Shop, but I actually unboxed them first. So, I actually unboxed them first. So, let's get into it. So, right, here we go. So, let's start off with the unboxing. So, the game's... So this game, Smart Timer, looks really cool, and I really like the design of it. Let's turn it on. And Gan actually installed batteries in mine, so good job, Gan. And so let's actually try it out. It's really cool. It actually lights up when you put your hands on it. So it's really, really, really cool. But anyways, moving on to the puzzles, which is the more exciting thing. Let's start off with the Wayland WRN. It's really cool, so I really like to... a lot of people main it, and still people do it, have it as their main. Let's do some first turns. Wow. That is fast. And it's really solid, like it's not gonna lock up on me. Really fast and flexible, and although one reason I don't like about it is that the magnets are kind of light, and I don't like weak magnets, so I like strong magnets. Anyways, I really like this cube, and Moya definitely did a good. They knew what setting I wanted on this cube and the WRM 2020. So good job, Moyu. So I'm really happy with you. So let's go back. So let's move on to the next one. So here's the Moyu Whale on WRM 2020, the updated version. It's basically the same cube, but it has different centerpieces. Let's do the first turns. Okay, not bad. It's really smooth and fluid. I really like it. This. This performs really well, and it does have the same compression system as the Wayland WRM. It looks the exact same, and again, Moya definitely did a good job of choosing the spring compression that I want. So good job, Moyu. Now, for a little demonstration, I really enjoyed cubing. I love of cubing, and it's really awesome. I really enjoy it a lot. So, two new orders are shipped and they're on the way. They are from Speak Cube Shop and the Cubicle. One of them has mystery puzzles, so you'll see. Really interesting. Alright, so the next puzzle we're gonna look at is the GAM 11M Duo. So this cube is at $47 and it weighs at 60 grams. It is actually lesser than the 11M Pro, which is its brother, and it's also 60 grams, but it costs $65 because there are no adjustable magnets and no adjustable core magnets. So this is just an updated version of the GAN 11M Pro, so it's really cool. Cool to see two cubes that are really similar. Like the GAN 256X is just the same cube as the 356M, but they just make the magnets not adjustable. Let's do some first turns. Oh yeah! Feels exactly the same as the 11M Pro. That's what I wanted. That's what I like about the 11M Pro. So, wrap. The GAN cubes have the GAN feel, which is really airy, smooth, soft, and buttery. It's really, really, really fluid as well. Really fluid, and I really like the performance of this 3x3 too. It's really, really good. I can spam my TPS on this. Let's do some H-perms. I'm like bad at H-perms, like Z2 cubing, but I can actually spam my TPS on this cube, so I don't have to worry. there's still lockouts on this cube because I don't perform as, because I turn really fast. And it's really, really cool. Looking at the compression system, it's the exact same as the 11M Pro and the XS. So this was first used in the XS. So it's really, really interesting, and I really like the design that GAN has go assisted. So GAN, find the right choice of screens for me. Anyway, let's go on to the GAN 356 I carry. This is a smart cube that's only $37. Let's see how well it performs on, let's do some first turns. Wow. It's really, really cool. So this actually performs really well. I really like the performance out of the GAN 356 I carry right now. It's really, really smooth, fluid, and I really like the tensions. Anyway, that is it for the video, and I'll see you in the next video. Bad. 19.71.